Absolutely. And so we've talked about generally what lean is in design, and then some of the waste that we want to attack. And now, Dan, we'll start to talk about phase planning and weekly work planning, two techniques that we can use to really drill into and understand how we can help the customer and make that process a lot leaner.
So phase planning operates at three levels. First of all, you milestone level, the strategic plan, the 30,000 foot plan. And you might think that means 50% DD, 95% DD, but there are probably some better milestones along the way. And they probably have to do with decisions that have to be made or approvals by a government agency that have to be made. And then there's the phase pull. The milestone pull, the strategic plan might be for the whole design sequence, but the phase pull might be for a much smaller chunk of work, a more manageable chunk of work. In construction, it's 2 to 4 months. In design, it may be, 2 to 4 weeks. It kind of depends on the speed of the design. And then once you have a phase pull, that means all the different steps involved, then you drop down to a weekly work plan so that there's accountability and a weekly check-in, and people are making sure they're giving what others need as they hand off work down the line.
So three levels, planning kind of big, long, yearly, planning a bunch of stuff, and then planning a week at a time. When we in BIM define information delivery milestones, we're defining what is required and who's required to do that from a team perspective. We have all of this content that we could start creating and putting in the model, but what happens if all of those teams start putting all of that content in at the same time? Well, we know, and we've just seen one of the ways clashes.
It's just
Clashes
all dump work. Yeah, right.
is, yeah, it just is all rework. So in order to combat that, it would be advantageous for teams to put their content into the model at the right time so that they don't have to move it.
Yeah.
And based on a priority structure, we have seen some incredible improvements. If we set the base and say these things are foundational, and then these things, for example, gravity piping that need to have the slope that need to be fixed before some of the more flexible, maybe the cable tray that routes around something,
Right.
it's able to really understand the sequence of events and how that can optimize things.
Yeah. The key is to do work first that releases other work.
Absolutely. And the principle is not starting everybody at the same time, but as you can see in these smaller bite-sized parts of the workflow, as we've planned out the milestones and the phases in the project, we can start teams at the right time and have their work always in place in the right place rather than that iterative looping that is necessary because that hasn't been planned as a sequence. So how can we use pull planning as a technique to help us? Dan, do you want to talk?
Yeah, the key word is pull. What it means is you start at the end and pull backwards. You move from right to left in planning. Of course, you're going to execute from left to right, but in order to plan, you want to start with the milestone you're pulling from and say what has to happen just before that, and then just before that, and then just before that. And in terms of designers, what information do I need to do my part of the design? Well, I want that to happen before me. And that's all we're doing here.
And so having a way of having a task that is represented maybe by a card, a sticky note in some way, we've seen much more powerful impact on the team when you have a visual.
Yes.
And then being able to use that, as you said, start at the end, plan backwards the sequence, put those tasks in order and write the notes and what I need in order to be able to do that. A lot of the time that plan is left on the wall.
Yeah, left on the wall. Yeah.
Some of the
In
challenge.
design, it's not that easy.
Absolutely, yeah, because everyone's gone back to their own offices. So there needs to be a way of capturing this. We have the ability to capture in a digital form that everyone has access to. And those tasks, those cards, can be represented as the period of time that they've just committed to, and also represented so that we can have the dependencies that they have asked for, and also the ability to have a checklist. So as we're going through this workflow, it's really important to be able to define that in electronic form as well with dependencies, et cetera.
And the nice thing about this is it integrates what was scoped in Plannerly with the actual tasks, so that we make sure we've got them all accounted for.